Hello and welcome to BASACast, where BASA is the choice of a new generation. I hope you all are enjoying the first few months of 2016 and the last few weeks of winter. As the seasons change, it gives us a chance to look back and observe all the great accomplishments of our December recitals. Biggest recital that BASA has ever hosted, and all the students and parents deserve a round of applause for their efforts. With the increasing need for speech, arts, and writing classes, we have once again expanded our teaching staff to meet this demand. We are very pleased to welcome a brand new writer in residence and welcome back a speech arts teacher from the past. Many of you may remember the friendly face of Ms. Harvey from a few years back. She was both a speech arts teacher and co-director of the theater program. After a very busy break from BASA, she is back. Ms. Harvey has been performing publicly since the age of 9, and as a teenager, she played a number of lead roles in film and television and in theater. She also trained and competed for 10 years as a classical soprano singer. She then went on to complete her BFA in acting at the University of British Columbia, during which time she received an Alberta Motion Picture Industry Award for Best Actress in a Lead Role. Her teaching career began at BASA in 2008, and since then she has performed in several feature films, toured across Canada with a play she co-created, and taught speech arts at her own private studio. She is delighted to be back at BASA, teaching full-time and relishing the support of this remarkable community. And we are very pleased to welcome Mr. Brond as our new writer-in-residence. Mr. Brond grew up in southern Alberta, where he attended the University of Lethbridge and received a Bachelor of Arts in English Literature. His love of writing then lured him to Ontario, where he received a Master of Arts in Creative Writing at the University of Windsor. He has been writing professionally for clients all across Canada. He is particularly proud of his work coordinating the publication of an art book for G Adventures, the world's largest independent travel company. This project meshed nicely with his love of travel, having once circled the globe on one very long adventure, the Himalayas in China, the desert forts of India, and the cobblestone squares of Europe. If you see either Mr. Brond or Ms. Harvey in the halls, feel free to say hello. With a new writer comes new and exciting programs to the writer's room, and our very own Ms. Fernette was lucky enough to sit down with the manager of the writer's room, Ms. Thompson, to talk about what's new in the world of the writers.
Thank you for joining me today.
Well, thanks for having me.
I'm sure many students at BASA already know about our writer's room, but for those who don't, could you sum it up for us?
The writer's room is a place where people can practice writing. Unfortunately, writing is one of the least practiced skills and one of the most important skills that any student can graduate high school with. And we believe that it's really important to practice at an early age and to keep practicing so that by the time students are finished high school, they have a sense of their own voice on the page and what makes them unique.
I find this so fascinating because growing up as a speech student, I never had the opportunity to have a writing program that coexists with my speech training. So for BASA to offer this to their students is a wonderful opportunity, and I'm quite jealous. Now, I've been hearing a buzz around the school about some programs that you've got going on in the writer's room. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
We are so excited about the pilots. The pilots are short classes right now where we're testing curriculum on students. And right now we're testing fiction curriculum and poetry and memoir curriculum. And we believe that if you're learning to write stories, you're learning so many skills. You're learning logic, you're learning not only expressing how to express yourself, but also how to convey major ideas and complex plots to an audience. And then with poetry and memoir, we believe it's important for kids to learn how to express what's happening on the inside on paper. So they will be not necessarily confessional works, but work that's closer to journaling.
Thank you so much, Ms. Thompson, for joining us today and keeping us in the loop with everything Writer's Room. For more information on everything the Writer's Room has to offer, please consult your instructor in your next private lesson. Back to you, Mr. Holmes.
Thank you, Ms. Thompson and Ms. Frenette. Last summer, some of the students of BASA were enrolled in the on-camera classes where they learned to write, act, and edit a movie. We produced 4 movies this year, and I'm pleased to say that the 4th and final movie is up on YouTube. You can see all of our movies from this past summer and previous summers by visiting our YouTube channel. Simply search for BASA The Bolton Academy, and you will be taken straight to our channel link. Here you will find all of our productions from previous BASACasts, films, and informative videos. And while you are there, please feel free to subscribe so you can instantly receive all of our videos from BASA. Our next big event at BASA before spring break will be the West Coast Festival for the Performing Arts. And here to tell you more about it is our very own Ms. Frenette on the frozen tundra of the Antarctic. Ms. Frenette?
Thank you, Mr. Holmes. The West Coast Festival for Performing Arts is another great opportunity for students of BASA to challenge themselves in front of an audience. The festival is divided into 2 categories, competitive and non-competitive. The non-competitive festival gives students a chance to perform their selected pieces for a small audience and 2 adjudicators. They will receive feedback forms from the adjudicators, plus a certificate showcasing their accomplishment. The competitive portion of the festival is for students who want to challenge themselves in competing against other students of their age in poetry, prose, and monologue recitation. Each student will receive a bronze, silver, or gold certificate for each piece, and 1 lucky student from each group will be chosen as the Adjudicator's Choice Award recipient. Both festivals will happen the week of March 5th to the 9th, and as always, if you have any questions about festival, please talk to your instructor. Back to you, Mr. Holmes.
Thank you, Ms. Frenette. After the West Coast Festival for the Performing Arts, we will officially be on spring break from March 11th to the 29th. However, we will be running a week-long spring break extravaganza with exciting programs to enroll in. And here, to tantalize your brains, is a commercial promoting the spring break classes at BASA.
So, do you have any plans for spring break, Stacy?
No. Do you, Nancy?
No.
You, Jesse?
No, I guess it's going to be another boring spring break.
Not at BASA! This spring break, BASA is your source for fun, with so many exciting programs to choose from, like debates.
I believe all children should have to wear uniforms at school.
No, they shouldn't.
News reporting.
This just in, BASA is awesome. Over to you, Nancy.
The weather today at BASA is challenging, but fun.
Interview prep.
Welcome to Harvard, and thank you for a great interview.
Thank you, Mr. Harvard, and thank you, BASA.
Creative voices.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Writing. Speech creation.
And so, my fellow BASA students, ask not what BASA can do at you, but what you can do at BASA.
Over spring break.
This spring break, BASA is your source for fun.
Spring break!
At BASA!
If you are interested in signing up for the spring break classes, online registration will be up on our website in late February. If you have any other questions, please talk to your instructor. Well, that's all the time we have for this week's BASACast. Until next time, have a happy spring break. See ya!
All the women in the pond.
Best you can do. You got a cheater.